This week on Maker Update, noise on wheels, Spotify on your desk, a butterfly bench, and a baby ball balancing bot. Hey, I'm Donald Bell, and welcome back to another episode of Maker Update, our show covering the latest projects and tips from the maker community. I hope you're doing well. We have another great show for you. Let's get started with a project of the week. The Noise Surround System by PanGenerator is an immersive audio installation where 8 motorized speakers zoom around on a track above your head. The speakers are each playing different sounds recorded from noises heard around the city. Car horns, traffic, subway noises. And though the speakers are wirelessly networked together over Wi-Fi, each of them is an entirely self-contained unit. Inside each one, you'll find a Raspberry Pi Pico W board running MicroPython, along with a speaker, a rechargeable battery, some LED lights, and a BLDC motor and driver board from an electric skateboard. To orchestrate the movement and the sound all together, the team created custom software using Node.js, along with an 8-channel sound mixer designed in Pure Data. For the structure, the tracks the speakers run on seem to be made from extruded aluminum, clamped to 6 towers that act as the main support. It's a very cool looking piece. It also seems like something you could scale up easily just by adjusting the length of the track. More projects. Check out PrestoDeck by Fatih Ak. This is a relatively simple project that uses the Pimaroni Presto display and turns it into a dedicated Spotify music controller. The Presto is a touchscreen display with Raspberry Pi Pico 2 capabilities baked in. Using the GitHub code and instructions, you can quickly set up the Presto with Spotify developer credentials that allow it to act as a controller. To be clear though, there's no audio coming from the Presto here. It's simply acting as a remote control for any of your Spotify connected devices. It looks cool though, and I like that the color changing LEDs on the back of the display adjust to the color of the album art on the front. On Adafruit, Erin St. Blaine shows how to build this light-up animated LED bench. In Erin's case, she's carved a beautiful butterfly design into the bench. However, the concept here really could be adapted to any design you want. The fun part here is to explore what's possible when you mash together WLED-controlled LED lighting effects and furniture design. Erin's guide includes everything you need to get going, including code, bill of materials, and even resources for finding easy-to-make plywood furniture designs. On Instructables, Johan Link has a new guide on how to build this small ball-balancing robot. He calls it the BaBot, and it's a smaller, simpler version of a ball-balancing design of his we covered back in 2019. But unlike his original design, which used an overhead camera system to detect the position of the ball, the BaBot now uses a platform with a matrix of IR sensors to determine where the ball is. The mechanical design is mostly 3D printed and only needs a few inexpensive hobby servos for the arms that adjust the platform. The code is open source and runs on the same ATmega32U4 chip found on the Arduino Micro. In this case, it's part of a custom PCB circuit that you can make yourself. Johan is also selling this as a kit available at ba-bot.com. Now for some tips and tools. On the Make Magazine blog, from Krizia Medero, aka So Printed, an in-depth guide on creating 3D printed fabric with embedded mirrors. In fact, you get to see the technique two ways. The first method shows how to introduce both the tool fabric and the mirrors in a single final step. In the second method, you pause once near the beginning to introduce the mesh, and then a second time near the end to introduce the mirrors. You can find a link to the step-by-step guide using the link in the description. Through the Core 77 blog, I learned about the Glue Looper. It's a tool for placing a single drop of CA glue into a project. It's designed to fit into any standard hobby knife. The end has a tiny ring that holds a drop of glue just using surface tension. For projects on a miniature scale or anything requiring very precise application of CA glue, this could be a useful option. On the Mishin Machine YouTube channel, a fascinating look at this 3D printed angular gearbox mechanism with a unique zero backlash design. What's interesting about the design to me is how the profile of the crown gears here take on a contoured wavy shape to stay in contact with the pins. It's a beautifully done video, and the journey to get to this design is really inspiring. On the Slant 3D channel, a great quick overview of different types of living hinges commonly found in 3D printed designs. And by living hinge, we mean a part of your design that is meant to flex or twist or stretch or compress without the addition of other pieces or hardware. Not only do we get to see some great examples, but we also get some useful tips on making your hinges even better and stronger. And whether you own a circular saw or not, you have to check out this video from YASUHIRO TV on 40 simple circular saw hacks. What you get is a series of ingenious, cheap, homemade jigs for making precise woodcuts in a small home workshop. Check it out. And for this week's DigiKey Spotlight, here's a great demo of DigiKey's own line of wire strippers and crimp tools. The line is called DigiKey Standard, and it offers a cost-effective way to get your hands on a high grade of these very useful tools. All right, and that does it for this week's show. Be sure to subscribe, leave a thumbs up, leave a comment if you can. Thanks to Krizia again for the use of their lab. They're an amazing resource for childhood science education in Barcelona, and I'll leave a link where you can learn more down in the description. Thanks as always to DigiKey for making this show possible, and thank you for watching. I'll see you soon.